Manning. The Germans reckon they are going to win.
Against us all?
Against us all. They are tremendously prepared.
It is impossible that Germany should win, said Mr. Britling, breaking his silence. Against her, Germany has something more than armies. All reason, all instinct. The three greatest peoples in the world.
At present, very badly supplied with war material.
That may delay things. It may make the task harder, but it will not alter the end. Of course we are going to win. Nothing else is thinkable. I have never believed they meant it, but I see now they meant it. This insolent arming and marching, this 40 years of national blustering. Sooner or later it had to topple over into action.
He paused and found they were listening, and he was carried on by his own thoughts into further speech.
"This isn't the sort of war," he said, "that is settled by counting guns and rifles. Something that has oppressed us all has become intolerable and has to be ended. And it will be ended. I don't know what soldiers and politicians think of our prospects, but I do know what ordinary, reasonable men think of the business. I know that all we millions of reasonable, civilized onlookers are prepared to spend our last shillings and give all our lives now, rather than see Germany unbeaten. I know that the same thing is felt in America, and that given half a chance, given just one extra shake of that foolish mailed fist in the face of America, and America also will be in this war by our side. Italy will come in. She is bound to come in. France will fight like one man. I'm quite prepared to believe that the Germans have countless rifles and guns, have got the most perfect maps, spies, plans you can imagine. I'm quite prepared to hear that they have got 1,000 tremendous surprises in equipment up their sleeves. I'm quite prepared for sweeping victories for them and appalling disasters for us,